Well, Costello, I'm going to New York with you. You know, Bucky Harris, the Yanks manager, gave me a job as coach for as long as you're on the team.
Look, Abbott, if you're the coach, you must know all the players.
I certainly do.
Well, you know, I mean, I never met the guys, so you'll have to tell me their names, and then I'll know who's playing on the team.
Oh, I'll tell you their names, but you know, strange it may seem, they give these ball players nowadays very peculiar names.
You mean funny names?
Strange names, pet names, like Dizzy Dean and...
His brother Daffy.
Daffy Dean.
I'm their French cousin.
French?
Gouffet.
Gouffet Dean, oh, I see. Well, let's see, we have on the bags, we have who's on first, what's on second, I don't know is on third.
That's what I want to find out.
I say, who's on first, what's on second, I don't know is on third.
Are you the manager?
Yes.
You're going to be the coach too?
Yes.
And you know the fellow's name?
Well, I should.
Well, then who's on first?
Yes.
I mean the fellow's name.
Who?
The guy on first.
Who?
The first baseman.
Who?
The guy playing
who
first.
Who is on first?
I'm asking you who's on first.
That's the man's name.
That's whose name?
Yes.
Well, go ahead and tell
That's
me.
That's it.
That's who?
Yes.
Look, you got a first baseman?
Certainly.
Who's playing first?
That's right.
When you pay off the first baseman every month, who gets the money?
Every dollar of it.
All I'm trying to find out is the fellow's name on first base.
Who?
The guy that gets the
That's
money.
That's it.
Who gets the money on
he
first?
He does, every dollar. Sometimes his wife comes down and collects it.
Whose wife?
Yes. What's wrong with that?
Look, all I want to know is when you sign up the first baseman, how does he sign his name to the
who?
Contract? The guy.
Who?
How does he sign his
That's
name?
That's how he signs it.
Who?
Yes.
All I'm trying to find out is what's the guy's name on first base.
No, what is on second base?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Who's on first?
One base at a time.
Well, don't change the players.
I'm not changing nobody.
Take it easy, buddy.
I'm only asking you, who's the guy on first base?
That's right.
Okay.
All right.
I mean, what's the guy's name on first base?
No, what is on second?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Who's on first?
I don't know.
Oh, he's on third. We're not talking about him. Now, let's begin.
How did I get on third base?
Why, you mentioned his name.
If I mention a third baseman's name, who did I say is playing third?
No, who's playing first?
What's on first?
What's on second?
I don't know.
He's on third.
There I go, back on third again.
Look,
will you stay on third base and don't go off it?
All right, I don't even know.
Now, who's playing third base?
Why do you insist on putting who on third base?
What am I putting on third?
What is on second?
You don't want who on second?
Who is on first?
I don't know.
Third base!
Look, you got outfield?
Sure.
The left fielder's name.
Why?
I just thought I'd ask.
Well, I just thought I'd tell you.
Then tell me who's playing left field.
Who is playing first?
I'm not. Stay out of the infield. I want to know what's the guy's name in left field.
No, what is on second?
I'm not asking you who's on
who's
second.
Who's on first?
I don't know. Third base. And the left fielder's name?
Why?
Because.
Oh, he's center field.
He is center field. Look, you got a pitcher on the team?
Sure.
The pitcher's name?
Tamara.
You don't want to tell me today?
I'm telling you,
then
man.
Go ahead.
Tamara.
What time?
What time what?
What time tomorrow you're going to tell me who's pitching?
Now listen, who is not pitching?
I'll break your arm, you say, who's on first. I want to know what's the pitcher's name.
What's on second?
I don't know.
Third base.
Got a catcher?
Certainly.
The catcher's name?
Today.
Today. And tomorrow's pitcher.
Now you've got it.
All we got is a couple of days on the
team.
You know, I'm a catcher, too.
So they tell me.
I get behind the plate, do some fancy catching. Tomorrow's pitching on my team, and a heavy hitter gets up.
Yes.
Now, the heavy hitter bunts the ball. When he bunts the ball, me being a good catcher, I want to throw the guy out of first base, so I pick up the ball and throw it to who?
Now, that's the first thing you've said right.
I don't even know what I'm talking about.
Well, that's all you have to do.
Is to throw the ball to first base.
Yes.
Now, who's got it?
Naturally.
I throw the ball to first base, somebody's got to get it. Now, who has it?
Naturally.
Who?
Naturally.
Naturally?
Naturally.
So I pick up the ball and I throw it to naturally.
No, you don't. You throw the ball to who?
Naturally.
That's different.
That's what I said.
You're not saying that.
I throw the ball to naturally.
You throw it to who?
Naturally.
That's it.
That's what I said.
Listen, you ask me.
I throw the ball to who?
Naturally.
Now you ask me.
You throw the ball to who?
Naturally.
That's it.
Same as you.
Don't change him around.
Same as you.
Go ahead, now get it over.
I throw the ball to who? Whoever it is drops the ball and the guy runs a second.
Yes.
Who picks up the ball and throws it to what? What throws it to, I don't know. I don't know, throws it back to tomorrow. Triple play.
Yes.
Another guy gets up and it's a long fly ball to because. Why? I don't know. He's on third and I don't give a darn.
What?
I said I don't give a darn.
Oh, that's our shortstop.
I'm an idiot. Come on.
We need a hit, so here I go.
Ball one.
Hey!
Ball two.
Hey!
Strike one.
Ooh!
Strike two.
Kill that umpire.
Yeah!
A case of Wheaties.
He's just a man and not a freak. Jolting Joe DiMaggio.
Joe, Joe DiMaggio, we want you on our side.
He tied the mark at 44, July the 1st, you know. Since then he's hit a good 12 more. Jolting Joe DiMaggio.
Joe, Joe DiMaggio, we want you on our side.
From coast to coast, that's all you'll hear of Joe, the one-man show. He's glorified the horsehide sphere, Jolting Joe DiMaggio.
Joe, Joe DiMaggio, we want you on our side.
He'll live in baseball's Hall of Fame, he got there blow by blow. Our kids will tell their kids his name, Jolting Joe DiMaggio.
We dream of Joey with the light from back. Joe, Joe DiMaggio,
we want you on our side. Whispers low of how they stopped our Joe. One night in Cleveland, oh, oh, oh. Goodbye, Street DiMaggio.
Go get it. Man, that ball's way in left field.
I don't care what field it's in. Willie plays all field.
Every time we come to the game, you're talking about Willie plays all the field.
That's right.
Let's call Willie and ask him. Call him.
Okay. Hey, Willie.
Yes.
Are you Willie Mays?
Yes.
Whose ball was that?
Why was it?
In left field.
Well, that's Irving's ball.
I told you that. Every time we come to the game, we got to talk about it. The next time, I'm going to sit in the grandstand.
Say, hey, fellas, what's your name?
Say who?
Say Willie. Say hey.
Say who?
Swinging at the plate. Say hey.
Say who?
Say Willie. That giant kid is great. When he hits the ball, it's long gone, man. Hits it farther than can't begin. Swings the bat like a little lead pipe. When they reach the ball, it's overripe. Say hey.
Say who?
Say Willie. Say hey.
Say who?
Swinging at the plate. Say hey.
Say
Willie, that giant kid is great.
He runs the bases like a choo-choo train. Swings around second like an aeroplane. His cap flies off when he passes third. And he heads home like an eagle bird.
Say hey,
say who?
Say Willie, say hey,
say who?
Swinging at the plate, say hey.
Of a center like he had jet shoes. The other batters get the Willie blues. Anything hit his way is out. Man, it just don't pay those guys to clout.
Say hey,
say who?
Say Willie, say hey,
say who?
Swinging at the plate, say hey,
say who?
Say Willie, that giant kid is great.
Served his Uncle Sam. He left the Giants in an awful jam. But now he's back and he's Leo's joy. And Willie's still a growing boy.
Say hey,
say who?
Say Willie, say hey,
say who?
Swinging at the plate, say hey,
say who?
Say Willie, that giant kid is great. That giant kid is great. Say Willie, gonna say.
Say hey.
Mickey who?
You know who, the fellow with the celebrated swing. Oh, I love Mickey.
Mickey who?
You know who, the one who drives me batty every spring. If I don't make a hit with him, my heart will break in two. I wish that I could catch him and pitch a little woo. I love Mickey.
Mickey who?
Mickey you.
Mickey me.
And that's who. Muscles are a mighty sight to see. Oh, I love Mickey.
Mickey who?
You know who, the one I want to steal right home with me. Oh, I'd sacrifice most anything to win his many charms. I'd like to be a fly ball and pop right in his arms. Oh, I love Mickey.
Mickey who?
Mickey Mantle.
Me?
Who? I love you.
Not Yogi Berra.
Who? I love you. Mickey!
Heaney Majeski, Johnny G, Eddie Juiced, Johnny Pesky, Thornton Lee, Danny Gardella, Van Lingo Mungo, Whitey Karowski, Max Lanier, Eddie Waitkus, and Johnny Vandermeer. Bob Estalella, Van Lingo Mungo, Augie Bergamo, Sigmund Jacoki, Big Johnny Mize, and Barney McCoskey, Hal Trosky, Augie Gullan, and Pinky May. Stan Hack and Frenchie Bordagaray, Phil Cavaretta, George McQuinn, Howard Paulette, and Early Wynn, Roy Campanella, Van Lingo Mungo. Augie Bergamo, Sigmund Jacoki, Big Johnny Mize, and Barney McCoskey, Hal Trosky, John Antonelli, Ferris Fane, Frankie Crosetti, Johnny Sane, Harry Brookine, and Lou Boudreau, Frankie Gustine, and Claude Passo, Eddie Basinski, Ernie Lombardi, Huey Mulcahy, Van Lingo Mungo.
So I say D, I say D-O, D-O-D, D-O-D-G, D-O-D-G-E-R-S, team, 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 O. I say O-M, O-M-A, O-M-A-L, O-M-A-L-L-E-Y, oh really, no O'Malley. Sandy Koufax, oh my Drysdale Maury Wills, I love you so. And we defy, defy the J-I, J-I-N, J-I-N-T, J-I-N-T-S, Giants! Play ball! Orlando Cepeda is at bat with the bases jammed. Orlando Cepeda with a wham, bam, he hit a grand slam in the very first inning, but it's only the beginning. In the third, like a fight, we get two on the way, then fairly hits into a double play. Here comes Big Frank Howard, yes siree, boy what a swing, strike three. O-dem B, O-dem B-U, B-U-M, B-U-M-S, them bums, them dry bums, oh they may be bums, but they're my bums. Top of the fifth, say hey Willie Mays, hits a three-bagger down the right field line, but he's out trying to stretch it to a homer as Roseborough tags him on the bottom of the spine with a crack you can hear all the way back up to San Francisco. Open your hospital! Inning six, Maury Wills draws a walk in the coach's box. Leo DeRocher, Leo DeRocher starts to wiggle and to twitch. A signal? No, an itch. Go, Maury, go, Maury, go, go, go. Maury goes, the catcher throws right from the solar plexus. At the bag, he beats the tag, that mighty little waif. And umpire Conlon cries, you're out! Out? Out? Down in the dugout, Alston glowers. Up in the booth, Vin Scully frowns. Out in the stands, O'Malley grins. Attendance 50,000. And what does O'Malley do? Bottom of the ninth, four to nothing, last chance, push the button. Oh, we're pleading, begging on our knees. Come on, you Flatbush refugees. Maury Wills at bat, hit it for me once. Stu Miller throws, Maury bunts. Cepeda runs the field of ball and Hiller covers first. Haller runs the backup Hiller. Hiller crashes into Miller. Miller falls, drops the ball. Conlon calls, safe. Yay, Maury! Gilliam up, Miller grunts. Miller throws, Gilliam bunts. Cepeda runs the field of ball and Hiller covers first. Haller runs the backup Hiller. Hiller crashes into Miller. Miller falls, drops the ball. Conlon calls, safe. Yay, Conlon! Willie Davis gets a hit and Tommy does the same. Here comes Mr. Howard with a chance to win the game. Hit it once! Big Frank bunts! Cepeda runs the field of ball, so does Hiller, so does Miller. Miller hollers, Hiller, Hiller hollers, Miller, Haller hollers, Hiller points to Miller with his fist. And that's the Miller, Hiller, Haller, Hallelujah twist! The Davis score, it's 4-4. Howard's still running the bases. From second to third, it's almost absurd. Amazement on everyone's faces. He's heading for home, he hasn't a chance. The poor nut is gonna be dead. But the ball hits him right in the seat of his pants. And he scores. That's using your head. So I say D. I say D-O. D-O-D-G-E-R-S. The team that's all heart, all heart and all thumbs, they're my Los Angeles. Your Los Angeles. Our Los Angeles. Do you think we'll really win the pennant? Bombs, ooh, them bombs.
Mm-hmm. Jefferson hit that ball. It went zooming across the left field wall. Yeah, boy.
Yes, yes, Jackie hit that ball.
And when he swung his bat, the crowd went wild because he knocked that ball a solid mile. Yeah, boy.
Yes, yes, Jackie hit that ball. Satchel Paige is mellow, so is Campanella. Newcomb and Dobie too. But it's a natural fact, when Jackie comes to bat, the other team is through.
Didn't you see Jackie Robinson hit that ball? Did he hit it? Yes! And that ain't all, he's so whole!
Yes, yes, Jackie's real gone. Jackie's real gone. Cause Jackie is a real gone guy. Yes, Jackie hit that ball.
And when he swung his bat, the crowd went wild because he knocked that ball a solid mile. Yeah, boy.
Yes, yes, Jackie hit that ball.
Satchel Paige is mellow, so is Campanella. Newcomb and Dobie too.
But it's a natural fact, when Jackie comes to bat, the other team is through.
Didn't you see Jackie Robinson hit that ball? Did he hit it? Yes! And that ain't all, he's so whole!
Yes, yes, Jackie's real gone. Jackie's real gone. Cause Jackie is a real gone guy.
I consider myself the luckiest man on the face of the earth. That I might have been given a bad break, but I've got an awful lot to live for. Thank you.
Three strikes, The Whiz Kids had won it, Bobby Thompson had done it, and Yogi read the comics all the while. Rock and roll was being born, marijuana we would scorn, so down on the corner the national pastime went on trial. We're talking baseball, Klazuski Campanella, talking baseball, the man and Bobby Feller, the scooter, the barber and the nuke. They knew them all from Boston to Dubuque, especially Willie, Mickey and the Duke. Well, Casey was winning, Hank Aaron was beginning, one Robbie going out, one coming in. Kiner and Midget Goodell, the Thumper and Mel Parnell, and Ike was the only one winning down in Washington. I'm talking baseball, Klazuski Campanella, talking baseball, the man and Bobby Feller, the scooter, the barber and the duke. They knew them all from Boston to Dubuque, especially Willie, Mickey and the Duke. Now my old friend, the Bachelor, well, he swore he was the Oklahoma kid, and Cookie played hooky to go and see the Duke. And me, I always loved Willie Mae, those were the days. Well, now it's the 80s, and Brett is the greatest, and Bobby Bonds can play for everyone. Rose is at the vet, Rusty again is a Met, and the great Alexander is pitching again in Washington. I'm talking baseball, like Reggie, Queez, and Berry. Talking baseball, Carew and Gaylord Perry, Seaver, Garvey, Schmidt, and Vida Blue. And it's no fluke, they'll be with Willie, Mickey and the Duke. Willie, Mickey and the Duke.
Say hey, say hey, say hey.
It was Willie, Mickey and the Duke.
Say hey, say hey, say hey.
I'm talking Willie.
The Northside diehard stole the show.
The land of Wrigley's in my soul. Come on, Cubbies, let the good times roll. Roll all day long.
Come on, Cubbies, let the good times roll. America's team, so I've been told. Come on, Cubbies, let the good times roll. Roll all day long. Don't stop until you've won. The Bleacher Bums are gonna have their fun. Roll all day long. It feels so good when you're home. Let's hear it for the Sunshine Boys.
You can't do no wrong.
On the road they beat them night or day. When they're at home they play the natural way. Come on, Cubs, hey, 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 hey. Sunshine Boys,
you can't do no wrong.
All your own clubs really can talk. Everybody knows they got the right stuff. Come on, people, how about those Cubs? Roll all day long. Roll all day long. Roll all day long.
Well, people, how about those Cubs?
The North Side diehard stole the show.
The land of Wrigley's in my soul. Come on, Cubbies, let the good times roll. Roll all day long.
Come on, Cubbies, let the good times roll. America's team, so I've been told. Come on, Cubbies, let the good times roll. Roll all day long. Come on, Cubbies, play it in the sun. Don't stop until you run. The Bleacher Bums are gonna have their fun. Roll all day long. It feels so good when you're home. Let's hear it for the Sunshine Boys.
You can't do no wrong.
On the road they beat them night or day. When they're at home they play the natural way. Come on, Cubs, hey, 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 hey. Roll all day long. It feels so good when you're home. Let's hear it for the Sunshine Boys.
You can't do no wrong.
All you're on the clubs really can talk. Everybody knows they got the right stuff. Come on, people, how about those Cubs? Roll all day long. Roll all day long. Roll all day long.
Well, people, how about those Cubs?
By the shores of old Lake Michigan, where the hawk wind blows so cold, an old Cub fan lay dying. In his midnight hour, the toll. Round his bed, his friends had all gathered. They knew his time was short. And on his head, they put this bright blue cap from his all-time favorite sport. Told him it's late. Getting dark in here, and I know it's time to go. But before I leave the lineup, boys, there's just one thing that I'd like to know. Do they still play the blues in Chicago when baseball season rolls around? When the snow melts away, do the Cubbies still play in their ivy-covered burial ground? When I was a boy, they were my pride and joy, but now they only bring fatigue to the home of the brave, the land of the free, and the doormat of the National League. Told his friends, you know the law of averages says anything will happen that can. That's what it says. But the last time the Cubs won a National League pennant was the year we dropped the bomb on Japan. The Cubs made me a criminal, sent me down a wayward path. They stole my youth from me, that's the truth. I'd forsake my teachers to go sit in the bleachers in flagrant truancy. And then one thing led to another, and soon I discovered alcohol, gambling, dope, football, hockey, lacrosse, tennis, but what do you expect when you raise up a young boy's hopes and then just crush them like so many paper beer cups, year after year after year, after year after year after year after year after year, till those hopes are just so much popcorn for the pigeons beneath the L tracks to eat. He said, you know, I'll never see Wrigley Field anymore before my eternal rest. So if you have your pencils and your scorecards ready, I'll read you my last request. He said, give me a doubleheader funeral in Wrigley Field on some sunny weekend day, no lights. Have the organ play the national anthem, and then a little na-na-na-na, hey, 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 goodbye. Make six bullpen pitchers carry my coffin, and six groundskeepers clear my path. Have the umpires bark me out at every base in all their holy wrath. It's a beautiful day for a funeral. Hey, Ernie, let's play too. Somebody go get Jack Brickhouse to come back and conduct just one more interview. Have the Cubbies run right out into the middle of the field. Have Keith Moreland drop a routine fly. Give everybody two bags of peanuts and a frosty malt, and I'll be ready to die. Build a big fire on home plate out of your Louisville Slugger baseball bats and toss my coffin in. Let my ashes blow in a beautiful snow from the prevailing 30-mile-an-hour southwest wind. When my last remains go flying over the left field wall, we'll bid the bleacher bums adieu. And I will come to my final resting place out on Waveland Avenue. The Dying Man's friends told him to cut it out. They said, stop it, that's an awful shame. He whispered, don't cry, we'll meet by and by near the Heavenly Hall of Fame. He said, I've got season's tickets to watch the Angels now. So that's just what I'm gonna do. He said, but you, the living, you're stuck here with the Cubs. So it's me that feels sorry for you. And he said, oh, play that Lonesome Losers tune. That's the one I like the best. Closed his eyes and slipped away. Scotty, it was the Dying Cub fans' last request, so here it is. Do they still play the blues in Chicago when baseball season rolls around? When the snow melts away, do the Cubbies still play in their ivy covered burial ground? When I was a boy, they were my pride and joy, but now they only bring fatigue to the home of the brave.
The game was almost done. Then God Hello there, everybody. This is Mel Allen. It's a bright, sunny afternoon, and what a beautiful day for a ball game. Swung that stick and that ball flew. Man alive, what a drive. A grand slam homer, that ain't no jive.
The teacher woke me up as I was heading for the plate. I had another class and it was getting kinda late.
Baseball is a dream for me, yeah. And the major leagues is the place to be.
You're right.
Baseball is a dream for me,
me too.
And the major leagues is the place to be.
Right on. 95 degrees at game time. That's a hot one. Reminds me of one of those old Brooklyn stickball days.
You got to say, hey, kid, Yaz, Aaron, and the Lick. All Street Hills, boys, take your pick. Let the ball bounce once, then take your swings. Touch those sewers as the neighborhood sings.
And by playing ball on the city streets, many youngsters have wide-eyed major league vision.
About 5'11". I go to work every morning at 7. At the office is tense, but I let off steam. Playing on the company's softball team. I got a new coat hanger for my black and white. I turned on the ball game on an August night. Drank a few beers, slipped into a dream. Dwight Gooden was pitching, I can hear the fans scream.
Here's the windup, the pitch, the count, 3-2. He swung that stick and that ball flew. Man alive, what a drive. A grand slam homer, that ain't no jive.
I was around the third, the coach slapped a high five. I got mobbed at the plate, the crowd came alive. Now it ain't no dream, for heaven's sake. I'm not asleep, I'm wide awake.
Baseball is the dream for me, yeah. And the major leagues is the place to be.
The pitch, the count, 3-2. He swung that stick and that ball flew. Man alive, what a drive. A grand slam homer, that ain't no jive. The windup, the pitch, the count, 3-2. He swung that stick and that ball flew. Man alive, what a drive. A grand slam homer, that ain't no jive. The windup, the pitch, the count, 3-2. He swung that stick and that ball flew. Man alive, what a drive.
It must have been June. I was having wet dreams over Wally Moon. He jumped into my bed. My body got hot. I said, come on, Walla, give me one more moonshine, cause I'm a baseball card lover.
He's a baseball card lover.
I'm a baseball card lover.
He's a baseball card lover.
I'm a baseball card lover. Honey, show me your cards. In his dream, it was carping a field from the second baseman, Charlie Neal. Through my spine, I was feeling chills. Went into my cover, slid Maury Wills. I'm a baseball card lover.
He's a baseball card lover.
I'm a baseball card lover.
He's a baseball card lover.
I'm a baseball card lover. Honey, trade me your cards. Oh, you gotta come home, dude. Come on. Little lower, Charlie. Little lower. Faster, faster, run, faster. Gil, that's where I like it, Gil. Oh, come on, Gil. Oh, God. Oh, that's where I like it. Oh, hit it, hit it. Oh, slide on it more. Come on, slide. Oh. Hands were shaking. I tried to relax. Went into my bed, climbed Santa Colfax. My legs felt numb. My face was pale. When joining the party was Don Drysdale. I hopped out of bed, ran into the shower, but picking up the soap was a big Frank Howard. I'm a baseball card lover.
Ooh,
I'm a baseball card lover.
Ooh,
I'm a baseball card lover. Honey, show me your cards.
Can you give us just a few basic comments about your feelings on the game?
Well, naturally, I feel bad about losing a ball game like that. There's no way you should lose that ball game, and that just doesn't make sense.
What's your opinion of Kingman's performance?
What's my opinion of Kingman's performance? What the f*** do you think is my opinion of it? I think it was put that in. I don't opinion of his performance. He beat us with three home runs. What the f*** do you mean, what is my opinion of his performance? How could you ask me a question like that? What is my opinion of his of his performance? He hit three home runs. I'm f***ed off to lose the f***ing game. And you ask me my opinion of his performance. I mean, that's a tough question to ask me, isn't it? What is my opinion of his performance?
Yes, it is. I asked it, and you gave me an answer.
Well, I didn't give you a good answer because I'm mad, but I mean...
That wasn't a good question.
That's a tough question to ask me right now. What is my opinion of his performance? I mean, you want me to tell you what my opinion of his performance is?
You just did.
That's right. Guy hits three home runs against us.
I paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence but committed no crime. And bad mistakes I've made a few. I've had my shares and kicked in my face, but I got through. Curtain call,
You brought me fame and fortune and everything that goes with it, and I thank you all. But it's been no bed of roses, no pleasure bruise. I consider it just for the whole human race.
Bobby Thompson takes a strike call on the inside corner. Bobby hitting at 292. He's had a single and a double, and he drove in the Giants' first run with a long fly to center. Brooklyn leads it 4-2. Hartung down the line at third, not taking any chances. Locked in without too big of a lead at second, but he'll be running like the wind if Thompson hits one. Franco throws. There's a long strike! It's going to be, I believe! The Giants run the pellet!
The outlook wasn't brilliant for the Mudville Nine that day. The score stood 4-2 with but one inning more to play. And so when Cooney died at first and Burrows did the same, a sickly silence fell upon the patrons of the game. A straggling few got up to go in deep despair. The rest clung to that hope which springs eternal in the human breast. They thought if only Casey could but get a whack at that, we'd put up even money now with Casey at the bat. But Flynn preceded Casey, as did also Jimmy Blake. And the former was a no-good and the latter was a fake. So upon that stricken multitude grim melancholy sat, for there seemed but little chance of Casey's getting to the bat. But Flynn let drive a single to the wonderment of all, and Blake the much despised tore the cover off the ball. And when the dust had arisen and the men saw what had occurred, there was Blake a safe at second and Flynn a hugging third. Then from 5,000 throats went up a lusty yell. It rumbled in the valley, it rattled in the dell. It knocked upon the mountain top and recoiled upon the flat. For Casey, mighty Casey, was advancing to the bat. There was pride in Casey's bearing as he stepped into his place. There was ease in Casey's manner and a smile on Casey's face. And when responding to the cheers, he lightly doffed his hat. No stranger in the crowd could doubt.
Twas a Casey at the bat.
10,000 eyes were on him as he rubbed his hands with dirt. 10,000 hands applauded as he wiped them on his shirt. And when the writhing pitcher ground the ball into his hip, defiance gleamed in Casey's eye. A sneer curled Casey's lip. And now the leather-covered sphere came hurtling through the air, and Casey stood watching it in laughter. A grandeur there, close by the sturdy batsman, the ball unheeded sped. That ain't my style, said Casey. Strike one, the umpire said. Then from the benches, black with people, went up a muffled roar, like the beaten storm waves on a stern and distant shore. Kill him! Kill the umpire! Cried someone on the stand, and it's likely they'd have killed him had not Casey raised his hand. With a smile of Christian charity, great Casey's visage shone. He stilled the rising tumult. He bade the game go on. He signaled to the pitcher. Once more the spheroid flew, but Casey still ignored it, and the umpire said, "Strike two!" "Hurrah!" cried the maddened thousands, and echo answered fraud. But one scornful look from Casey, and the multitude was awed. They saw his face grow stern and cold. They saw his muscles strain. And they knew that Casey wouldn't let that ball go by again. The smile is gone from Casey's face. His teeth are clenched in hate. He pounds with cruel violence his bat upon the plate. And now the pitcher holds the ball, and now he lets it go. And now the air is shattered by the force of Casey's blow. Oh, somewhere in this favored land, the sun is shining bright. Somewhere bands are playing. Somewhere hearts are light. Somewhere men are laughing. And somewhere children.